Good evening. I'd like to call to order our regular scheduled council meeting for Monday, July 1st, 2013. First order of business is our opening ceremony, which consists of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence for those service members that have given their lives while defending our country. Would everybody please stand? Ms. Bettis, you take the roll, please.
Good evening, Your Honor. Mayor Walker?
Here.
Councilmember Squires?
Here.
Councilmember Curl?
Here.
Councilmember Lynch?
Here.
Councilmember Fetter?
Here.
Councilmember Dodge?
Here.
Councilmember Jones?
Here.
Okay, the next item is the approval of the agenda as presented.
So moved. Support.
Moved by Councilmember Lynch, supported by Councilmember Dodge. Any discussion from the table? From the general public? Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Lynch?
Aye.
Councilmember Dodge?
Aye.
Councilmember Jones?
Aye.
Councilmember Fetter?
Aye.
Councilmember Curl?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. We have no community announcements tonight. We have no state or county officials here. We have no petitions or communications, no public hearings. We move on to the consent agenda.
Mayor?
Ms. Lynch?
I move for the approval of the consent agenda items 9A1 and 2.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Jones. Discussion from council. From the general public. Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Lynch?
Aye.
Councilmember Jones?
Aye.
Councilmember Dodge?
Aye.
Councilmember Fetter?
Aye.
Councilmember Curl?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. We move on to our study session. Item one, city manager's contract. Ms. Dodge, is there any updates?
Nope, we're just doing our due diligence.
Okay. Any other discussion on this matter, council? Okay, we move on to item two, resolution recognition. You guys wanna move that to C?
Yep.
Yeah, sure.
And we wanna have a special joint council meeting over at the police station on Monday, July 29th with the DDA and the Planning Commission. Is there a certain time you guys would like to make that?
I don't think there'll be enough room, do you?
We can change
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I think so.
We can set it up differently than we have before, but if that's not good enough, then we can move it later.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Sure.
What time do you guys want?
6:30.
6:30?
So I'll have time to.
Mm-hmm. All right, 6:30. All right, we'll need to move that to C then.
July.
Okay, we will move on to the C agenda. Item C2, resolution of recognition for Richard Fernandez.
Mayor?
Mr. Kerwin.
Yeah, I'd like to read this.
You want to make the motion first, sir?
Yeah, I'll make a motion that we accept the resolution.
Support.
Support from Councilmember Jones. Go ahead and read it,
okay, Mr. Kerwin. This is a resolution of recognition in the City of Garden City, County of Wayne, State of Michigan. Whereas, after nearly 20 years, couldn't make it one more month, right, Dick? As the Nacon Transit Commission Executive Director, Richard, commonly known as Dick Fernandez, is retiring effective July 1st, 2013. And whereas he has been recognized by the Suburban Mobility Authority for Regional Transportation, that's SMART, for his efforts in establishing voter-approved funding for the system. And whereas he has partnered with Garden City Hospital to provide transportation to medical facilities for seniors and the disabled. And whereas he has had a passion for providing transportation for the underserved market, striving to make sure the needs of those less fortunate are met. And whereas he has been a community leader serving on the Garden City Council from November 1981 to November 1985. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the City Council of the City of Garden City officially acknowledges and commends Richard Fernandez for his considerable contributions to the public.
Very good. Congratulations, sir. Come on.
Wait.
May I take a picture for Mr. Fernandez? Would that be all right, sir?
Sure.
Dick, thank you very much. Scholar, I appreciate it.
No, they serve on Lincoln Transit.
I like them, but I'm getting sick of hugging them, Kathy.
Oh, smile.
Thank you.
Especially your job.
Oh, appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you for everything. Congratulations, sir. Okay. Have a good retirement.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Richard, I want to thank you and let everybody know, Richard was asked to take this job for 2 years and stayed for 20. You had the biggest direct input of the lives of the people in our city than anybody I've dealt with. And I'm on a lot of committees. You're personally responsible for the health and well-being and the independence that our elderly feel today. There's nothing worse I've heard from people than to lose the privilege to drive and to get out. And you and your organization have kept that dream alive for hundreds and thousands of our people in our city. I'm extremely proud to know you at a business level and a personal level. And I'd like to thank you for everybody in this town. You will be truly missed. And this Nacon Transit system is what it is today because of what you did yesterday. So thank you very, very much. And when you go into your retirement, don't feel it was for naught. You've meant a lot to a lot of us here in this city. So thank you very much, Mr. Fernandez.
Mr. Kerwin, were you saying anything?
No, sir.
Oh, I thought you had your hand up. Ms. Lynch?
I was just going to say Mr. Fernandez has been not only active with Nacon Transit, but in many facets of Garden City and different groups and organizations. And we hope that you're not going to be missed other than at Nacon Transit, of course. We hope to see you around the community just like we always have, maybe even more so now that you're retired. Thank you for all your years.
Mayor? Mr. Jones?
Yeah. I'd like to second the words of my colleagues. I'd known Richard and his involvement before he was on City Council in Nacon Transit, and he was an active member of our community then, and we certainly appreciate his many years of service.
Absolutely. And again, thank you for your service, and have a great retirement.
Thank you very much.
Any comments from the general public? Ms. Bettis, you can take the vote.
Councilmember Kerwin.
Aye.
Councilmember Jones.
Aye.
Councilmember Dodge.
Aye.
Councilmember Fetter.
Aye.
Councilmember Lynch.
A resounding yes.
Councilmember Squires.
Aye.
Mayor Walker.
Aye. Moving on to item C3, the special council meeting for Monday, July 29th at 6:30 p.m. at the police station.
Mayor?
Ms. Lynch?
I move to call for a special joint city council meeting with the DDA and Planning Commission for Monday, July 29th, 2013 at 6:30 p.m. at the police department.
Support.
Support from Ms. Squires. Discussion from the table, from the general public. Ms. Bettis?
Councilmember Lynch?
Aye.
Councilmember Squires?
Aye.
Councilmember Jones?
Aye.
Councilmember Dodge?
Aye.
Councilmember Fetter?
Aye.
Councilmember Kerwin?
Aye.
Mayor Walker?
Aye. Okay, we will move on to public comments if we're not on the agenda. Anybody wishing to speak? Come up to the podium, state your name.
My name's David Hamlin. I live at 32443 Florence, Garden City. And this is the first time I've ever done anything like this. I don't like actually having to do it. But it's got to be done because I'm a big boy and it's just got to get done. What's happened is almost 5 years ago, you brought on an ordinance officer fresh out of ROTC and Police Academy. I believe he missed one day of training. And what I mean by that is the previous ordinance officer, Ken Tenza, he came over to my house years ago and explained to me exactly what I'm getting ready to explain to you, that he has to give out the original citation that has a duplicate. The next thing for cases where there's accumulative debris or something like that, he has to take the long form, fill it out just like the ticket, turn it over, put a carbon copy in the last two pages, actually draw a picture, and state on there exactly what he wants done. 5 years ago almost, me and my wife, we went to Alaska to see my son before he went to Iraq. And we didn't get there before Angelo put a sticker on my door. We weren't even going to be back by the time it was supposed to have been dealt with. Now, we were talking almost 5 years ago, so that all is all ancient history. But the thing I didn't realize through this is that through the courts, I've learned that he has to actually report everything that he does to you guys. I didn't realize it went this involved. Otherwise, I'd have been here much sooner. So here I am, 5 years later, still in a relentless pursuit of Angelo DeMichael. I have not a problem one bit doing everything that is asked of me. The only thing I ask is that it's a level playing field like it once was. Now, that's the only thing that we went to court last week for the arraignment. And I explained this to him now for the third time, that I am still waiting for him to give me the long form, filled out properly, turned over with a diagram picture explaining exactly what he wants. Because for the first 2 years, he walked up to my house. I was always there when he walked up. And my first question to him was, every time was, is it looking better? Because to me, it did. But his answer for the first 2 years was, no, it's not up to my specifications. Now, I bring 2 years into it because that's the point to where it switched from us actually talking to him saying, well, I'm done talking, I have to start writing. I said, well, okay, our conversations are now over then. I mean, there's no sense in talking if there's no dialogue. And so I went ahead, and now the third year he came. It's always, the weird thing of it is, I'm always out there at least a month and a half working feverishly, actually, in my backyard, because I'm a hyperactive 53-year-old guy. There's nothing outside I don't know how to do, just about. My dad's been in rental real estate all my life, and I had a small taste of it, and I didn't like it. And so I've decided I actually retired in 96. Since then, I've decided that I go to church on Sunday and I go to work for God on Monday. After that, the rest of the week is mine. So, since the last 2.5 years, even my grandkids are asking me, Grandpa, when are you going to be done working?
Yeah, 30 seconds, sir.
Okay. That's where we're at. My grandson asked me that. My neighbor kids even asked me, even yesterday, how come you work so hard in your yard? And I just keep telling them. I asked my dad when I retired, how do you go to sleep at night? And he said, I go out and do a full day's work every day, and I have no problem going to sleep. I've just tried to emulate that.
Your time's up.
Okay.
I will have the city manager look into this and get back with you. Okay, and it sounds like you're already in court.
I'm in the pocket here.
Yeah, well, it's a court matter if you're in the court system, right. But I'll also have the city manager look into your complaint.
I know you guys have the powers to help.
Yeah, I will. We'll look into it. Okay. Anybody else? Mr. Buckner.
With that, I bid you good night.
Okay. Thank you.
John Ronick, the gentleman, is talking tonight about we have our own problem in our own front yard. We're going around harassing the citizens when DDA, whatever they like. And then I can side with the gentleman here. When I started coming to these meetings, for 10 years, I didn't have no problems. Nobody's know this. I never spoke about it. But I've got a stack of those stickers as well. And that'll come out later on. I would like to thank the part-time acting city manager for getting me the information on the city attorney fee. Dave Vetter was right. Some on this council, and now Bob Murray, are running up thousands of dollars in talking to the attorney. I have a business and a lawyer, and whenever I called him, he details the call, the time, the subject, and the amount. And after thousands of dollars spent on the advice from the attorney, Walker, Lynch, and Dodge still voted yes for Bob Murray for city manager. It was done illegally. The panel to decide Bob Murray's contract, first of all, we have Lynch and Dodge, the same two that were on council in 2006 that cost us $15 million lawsuit that we still have 7 years to pay at $1.3 million per year. They're the last two, I think, that should be up here figuring out a new contract that's going to cost us even more. I'd like to give Sue Buck a high five for covering the story that she has been the last few weeks. She's been very correct with her facts, and I would hope she will continue to do so. Walker, you stated in the Observer that you're not concerned that there isn't a contract yet. That's the whole problem up here. We need some firm leadership. We do need some concern. And then you went on to say you wanted the process to be done correctly. If that was the case, you wouldn't have broke the Incompatible Public Official Act of 1978 by voting in the acting city manager. You just can't make this stuff up. This is all of your doing. And I would ask that you would get back into being the true leadership that you think that you are, and let's get this council back to where it should be. The part-time acting city manager gets him $35 extra day now. Just to say if we give him a contract at $40,000, that's an extra $110 a day that he'll be making, on top of the $2,000 he makes as chief of police. That's $132,000 per year, plus benefits, plus two pensions. Dave Vetter is right. He will cost us millions when he retires. The real cost, though, is $2.1 million over 20 years. Now, Walker, in all your intelligence, you said in the last meeting that we pay the city manager $100,000 per year, and in 20 years, it would still be about $2 or $3 million if you add in the benefits. You forgot to add Bob Murray's pension of the $2.1 million on top of the $2.3 million you'll be paying for a city manager to do the job as well. Now, add that together, and you've inflated the price from 2.1 that Fetter points out to really it's going to be between $4 and $5 million that it's going to cost the city for the next 20 years. Now, citizens, can't you see how Walker's way of thinking and doing business is destroying what little Garden City is left? Mr. Fetter was also right on the opinion of the present council in regards to rehiring of the city attorney. We have got a chance to move ahead, and make intelligent moves. But no, we take two steps back, one step forward, and we're still stuck in the motion going nowhere fast. I'm confused about the passing of the fixed water rate. I thought, Walker, you said you were going to cut the rate for the people. You did the opposite. You cut it for the business. Now, let's just take several cities have a second meter, and the only charge for water goes through it, not the sewage. The reason why this council don't want to do that, because they'll be losing millions of dollars. I thought this council was concerned about the high rates of water for residents, such as Robert Smith. And not really, all they gave him was a 10% discount. Now, getting back to my point, the businesses will see a notable savings if they really use a large amount of water, such as Kroger, Garden City Hospital, and the laundromats. Now, Walker claims that about 52%, or about 6,100 residents, will be saving about $60 more or so. And those are the ones that are on a fixed income or single parents. As a homeowner, we will see the increase.
Yeah, 30 seconds, Mr. Buckner.
Think about this. We, the homeowners, pay most of the taxes, vote in the tax site, and then when Walker can reward us for standing behind him, he refused to give back our millions of dollars and overcharge us in the water. Walker, we need you to be the leader that you should be, give back the people their money, and do what is right for the city of Garden City. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? Mr. Wallace.
It's a sleepy day out there. I think everybody should wake up. I'm going to tell you a little story. There's some young couple, well, not a young couple, 50 years old. They're walking down the beach. They just come out of church. And they walk on this beach, and the lady looks down, and she sees this beautiful bottle, and she picks it up. Jeannie comes out. She says, "You've got one wish." She says, "I really want to travel all over the world. I'd like to have tickets to go everywhere." Smoke comes out. She looks around, the smoke clears, and there's tickets for all over the United States, all over the world. Jeannie says, "Hey," says, "Sir, you have a wish too." Now remember, they're 50 years old. And he says, "I always wanted to have a wife that was 30 years younger than me." And smoke comes out, and it clears, and he turned to 80 years old. We got to have some fun. But anyway, I want to talk about the chain of command. We were talking about shooting, the Attorney General not making any statements, anything. But let me tell you something. When you're in the union and you have something wrong go wrong, you don't go and call the Chief Sturt right away. You call the committee man. And then you can walk up the stair of... to where you get to where you have no other law. It's just like a court. You go to court, you don't go to the Supreme Court first. So what Schutte was actually telling everybody is you take things in order. You take things local and take them to the county and then to him. But right on the thing that I read in the paper and the Free Press and all the everything I've read, it says that it's against the law to have a little position. Now, am I right that our attorney give a written opinion? Because some people ask me, when are we going to get a written opinion? I was told we already have one. All you guys have one. Laws are not made to be broken. If that be the case, I go out here and I rob a store. But nobody catches me. I didn't break a law. I robbed a store. But nobody caught me, nobody seen me. I didn't break the law. Oh, my goodness. Things are getting worse and worse and worse. We have no order. And I'll repeat again, like the people said, how do we get rid of the people that caused us a lawsuit before? There's people calling me that want to get a class action. I said, don't do a class action. If you want to sue, sue individually. Because if you sue a class action, the blood-sucking attorney takes all the money. If you want to sue individually, sue them. But you can't sue till something's gone wrong. But it will happen. It will happen. People's not going to sit back and let a $15 million lawsuit happen again. They're not going to do it. But anyway, thank you for your time.
Thank you. Anybody else? Mr. Bacham.
Good evening.
Yes, I'm sorry. Yes.
Edison, I talked to him about 3 weeks ago, and I haven't heard from them. I talked to the city clerk last week, and helped me get the lights not fixed at Bellton and Chambers. They tore it down, 2 trees down, and they took the line down. It's just hanging there.
The line's hanging on Warren Road?
On Warren, Bellton and Chambers. They cut the line. 2 trees cut it. They put the line back in. I tried to edit. I help me. They give it. Don't bother me.
Who said that?
Edison.
Okay. They probably know about it already. They already know about it, probably.
I talked to Miss Bell. I helped. Last week, I was out. A policeman on the back row asked for help. They didn't do nothing. Edison didn't do anything.
I know, Mike. I don't know what I can do about Detroit Edison. I've tried.
I tried too, but they give me a dirty look. Nasty. Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Buckle. Anybody else? Okay. City manager, his wife is ill, so that's why he's not here tonight. So there'll be no city manager's report. We'll move on to Ms. Dodge. Do you have anything?
First, to Mrs. Murray, I hope you're feeling better soon. I don't like to see you under the weather. Mr. Bacco, our fire chief is going to drive by there and see what's going on and then make the necessary calls, okay? Okay. No, she knew she was going to go by there. She might not see anything, but whatever she sees, she'll, you know, take care of it. Okay, I need to, this past week I have gotten a multitude of phone calls from past city employees, our retirees, UAW retirees, regular off-the-street retirees, senior citizens, regarding statements that have been made regarding retirement benefits. Now, first thing that, and some of the twisted facts were given tonight at the podium, first thing people have to realize, our retirees, they pay into the system from day one. This is not something that the city just all of a sudden, Chief, you're retiring tomorrow? Here's 20 years worth of retirement. No, we don't do that. No, you're not retiring. You're not going anywhere. It is something that is built up in our pension system. Per the state laws, cities never touch that pension system. The city pays in, the employee pays in. They actually build that money into a bigger sum of money by playing in the stock market and other different types of things. So it's not something where an employee retires and all of a sudden we have to cough up $1.4 million or what's been bandied around $2.1 million, where I don't know where this number comes from, considering we haven't even talked monies with the chief. People have been upset. Seniors that are on Social Security, they says, well, I'm multiplying what I get monthly out 20 years, and boy, I'm costing you over $600,000 of your tax dollars. Well, they're right. When you look at it that way, when you take somebody's retirement, multiply it out 20 years, you know what? You're going to get a large number. Now, you're going to forget, you also can't forget that these people are paying taxes. You can turn your head as much as you want, but I bet you get a retirement. Tell me how much you get monthly. We'll multiply that out by 20 years, and that's what you're saying to the public. It's wrong. That money they have put in there, they have several different options when they retire. They can take it all at one time. It's taxed. They can do option one, option two, option three. That's entirely up to the employee. But that money has already been put in the system. That money is due these retirees and all the other retirees across the world that have paid into a pension system. I think you're being very, very, very unfair. And then to turn around and say that the chief is getting two paychecks and he's going to get pension on top of a pension, how can you say that? Do you know something that we don't know? Because that's the farthest thing from the truth. And when you say we have broke the law, guess what? We've offered the man a position. He hasn't been hired, not until this full council agrees to a contract. So please quit twisting things out of proportion. It's wrong. It's not like Fecano when he says, okay, gee, and you walk out the door with thousands of dollars. This is not the same thing. This is a system the employees have paid into since day one. They are due these monies, and they are paid out over years. Taxes are taken on top of those monies once they do retire. So I think you need to be fair to everyone. I mean, we had a former police chief retired very, very, very young. We'll go 20 years out, adding a 2% COLA, cost of living increase. This is not just, I like you, I'm giving you 2% a year. This is a 2% cost of living increase. Just multiplying that out for the 20 years, and we know this person's gonna live at least 40 more years. You're looking at $1.4 million before taxes and before they hit a certain age that Medicare, Medicaid will kick in. So please, put things in the right text. Don't just multiply things out and make people think that, gee, somebody leaves out the door and we're gonna be paying them millions, because that is not the truth. And that's all I have to say.
Thank you, Ms. Dodge. Mr. Jones?
I too am tired of scare tactics being used based on incomplete information to try to upset the public, and I would like to see us proceed in a more civil manner and discuss these things in appropriate time frames when they're on the agenda to be discussed as completed items. That's all.
Thank you. Ms. Lynch?
I too have been getting telephone calls from people asking about the retirement, and they couldn't believe the numbers that were being said. They said, where did they come from? And I had to agree with what Mrs. Dodge said, and she covered most of what I was going to say, because those numbers are not accurate numbers. There are people that, when you multiply retirements over many, many years, when they give half of the money themselves, you can't talk about retirements in the same way. But the one thing that was forgotten to be added to it is, for probably, and Ms. Bettis, correct me if I'm wrong, 10 or 12 years, the city never put one penny into the pensions, because our system was funded and then overfunded, and we were getting good interest rates on our investments and everything else. So as it's being said that every year we're paying all this big money into it, some years we pay, some years we pay a little, some years we pay more. But it's not just a given that we will pay 50%. It's based on the different investments and what's going on as well. So I'm going to agree with Mrs. Dodge, and that 2% increase, the cost of living increase, that was very deceptive, because I know that all of our unions are getting the 2% COLA increases, but that's what they get for working for many, many years. And Social Security doesn't always get those, but they do too get COLA increases. So you can't fault the city or one contract and things like that. That's ridiculous. And that's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Bettis?
Your Honor, all of our residents should have received in the mail, if they pay their taxes themselves as opposed to a mortgage escrow, they should have received their tax bills. I did take the liberty of putting those before council as well. I just wanted to say thank you very much for the purchase of the new system. It was much more productive. It was, we feel, a better product came out, and I know it's taxes, and I know nobody's happy about taxes, but if you gotta have taxes, that's the best way to do it. And I did want to say thank you to the residents and council for that. And to remind everybody that, yes, they're taxes, but they're the taxes that go to making sure that these fine officers come to your house when there's trouble afoot, that these fine firefighters come and make sure that they take care of your property when there's an accident, that my wonderful staff coordinates everything so that that those firefighters and police officers and other and ordinance officers and all of those good people who work hard for the citizens of the city are paid so that they can feed their families. And that's what your tax dollars go to, and we appreciate it.
May I respond?
Thank you. Mr. Jones?
Just like Mrs. Bettis to know that the check's going to be in the mail on August 30th.
All right, I'll be waiting.
Mr. Kerwin?
Yes, sir, I only have two things. I was going to bring them both up last week, but I've talked to several people about the DDA area where the paving brick are kept. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a eyesight. I've driven by there several times. I think the pallet on the far north side looks like they keep stealing from it, and there's brick and crap all over the place. And also the dumpsters at Kmart or Albert's on the Alley, all the stores there. I don't know, there's got to be five or six or seven of them, and they really are a sight for sore eyes. And I know that was put out to bid. It's got to be probably 4 or 5 years ago, and then it was canceled. So I don't think that over here on the Kroger side, but something needs to be done over there. That's terrible. Okay. So just if you could mention that to the chief or to the
yes, sir.
What do you got, city manager?
Yes, sir.
And let them know about the bricks and the dumpsters.
Yes, sir.
That's all I have. Thank you. Okay.
Mr. Fetter?
Nothing tonight, Your Honor.
Sure.
I'm sure.
Quick, move on. Quick.
I'm sure. Nothing.
Ms. Squire?
Just quickly, thank you, Mrs. Dodge and Mrs. Lynch and Mr. Jones for clarifying that. And I hope people listened to what you had to say about the contract. Thank you very much, and that's all I have.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'm not going to say much more. Ms. Dodge and Ms. Lynch covered it pretty well. Ladies and gentlemen at home, not everything you hear at this podium from some residents is true or factual. Just keep that in mind, which I'm sure you do. We're trying to do the right thing. We do the right thing, and we will continue to do the right thing. With that, no further business. This meeting is adjourned.
Yes, sir.
Where's the lady? 37, 36.
Oh, okay. Thank you.